This demo number 4 provides an introduction to the FastGraph screening function. This is one of the most useful and beneficial features of the FastGraph's research tool available only to the premium subscriber. The screening tool allows the premium subscriber to custom design and search the database of over 16,000 symbols for whatever kind of stock they are seeking, whether it be growth, dividend pairs, etc. By utilizing this powerful function, the subscriber can hone in on identifying the specific types of stocks they are looking for, possibly saving them hours of laborious effort and work. The screening tool can be accessed by simply clicking on the screening button at the top of the navigation bar to the left of the FastGraphs, and that will take you to the screening section of the FastGraph research tool. Once the premium subscriber is in the screening tool, there are several inputs that they can override and manipulate in order to focus on and hone in on the exact items that they're screening for. The first step would be to create a portfolio name, and we're going to create a portfolio here called Consumer Staples Dividends. Once I've typed in Consumer Staples Dividends, I can now go through the various other inputs and utilize them to make my list more relevant to what I'm looking for. First of all, I'm going to keep my list size small so that I can create a small list very quickly. The bigger the number you utilize in the list size maximum, the longer it takes the screen to run. I'm going to leave the I ratio minimum at 2.5. That stands for earnings yield estimator, and it is a valuation metric that we leave at the default setting. But I'm going to take the estimated growth rate minimum and change it from 12% to 8% to be more realistic. Then I'm going to change the historical growth rate minimum to 8% as well. In order to screen for a proper historical period, I'm going to limit my search to 15 years of history, and I'm going to also be realistic by adding a historical estimated total return of 10% or better. I'm going to leave the price minimum section at $5 or better. I don't want any penny stocks. I'm going to ignore the debt maximum column for my first set of screens here, but then I'm going to add 1% dividend yield minimum. I'm going to leave my valuations alone. By simply typing in or deleting any of these numbers, I can look for either very low, low in the value corridor, or overvalued or very highly overvalued stocks if I even want to add a 4. This just simply expands my list. Then most importantly for this screen, I'm going to choose the sector that I want. And since we're calling this the Consumer Staples Dividend Portfolio, I'm going to screen only for consumer staples. And then on cap rate selection, I'm going to allow any cap size that the screen would search for. Next, I'm going to put these in dividend yield order since I'm focused on dividends here. And I'm going to check this little box that includes ADRs. And then once all that is done and I've reviewed this and everything's to my liking, I've got a list size max of 10. I've got estimated growth rate of 8, historical growth rate of 8. I'm going to look at 15 years of history. I have a maximum estimated future return of 10%. Left everything else pretty much a default, but I did ask for a minimum of 1% dividends. I've chosen my sector. I want this to create a portfolio review in dividend yield order. I simply click on the screening button and it will begin flashing as the screening process has begun. The subscriber will know that the first set of screens has stopped when the screening button quits flashing, and you also create another button that says restart screening at the beginning if they wanted to start over. But what you'll see here is that so far we've gone through 3,103 out of a possible 16,503 symbols. And what we've come up with here is our list of 10, since we limited our selection to 10 names. A portfolio review has been created that allows several fundamental metrics to be listed, and the user can actually manipulate what size and how many columns on this table that they would choose. But once this is created, since we're using a small section here, we would recommend printing this so that you can look at these companies later. In order to continue with the screening process to go through the entire database, we simply click the screening button again, and once again, the user will see that it begins flashing. When the flashing screen button is quit flashing, once again, the next set of 10 selections have been screened. And then again, we recommend that these are printed. But you'll notice here now that we've gone through 11,874 out of 16,503 possible. Since we're getting to the end of our possible choices here, it'll probably take one more screening button before we'll exhaust the entire set. I just simply click the screening button again, and once again, it starts flashing. When the screening button quits flashing for the final time, the resume screening button disappears, and now we have our complete screen set of names from our consumer staples selection of companies paying at least a 1% dividend yield. Notice that each set was listed in order of dividend yield as we asked it to in our drop-down window here. Once this is complete, you can hit your back button and go back to your previous screens so that you can go through the portfolio companies now one at a time at your liking. To review each of the individual fast graphs on each company, you just simply click the button here, and this creates normal fast graph. Once you're in the actual fast graph, it's suggested that you click this Show Portfolio Update button and then hit the Go button once again. This will create a drop-down window that will allow you to add companies to the portfolio you've selected. By simply hitting the Go button, we can add whatever company is on the screen into the Consumer Staples Dividend portfolio that we wish to create. And you'll notice that the word in with two asterisks to the side has now been created. We can continue through our list by just hitting this arrow, and the next name will then show up. And then once again, we can decide if we want to add this to our Consumer Staples portfolio or not, by simply hitting this button, and it'll show us that it's now in the Consumer Staples Dividend portfolio. We just continue repeating this process one company at a time until we've built all the stocks in the portfolio that we choose to look at. If there are names that come up that we do not want in the portfolio that we don't think meet our criteria, we simply don't add them to the portfolio list. However, if they are already in the Consumer Staples list, then we can simply hit this Go button and delete them from the list. The screening function of the FastGraph research tool is very easy to use and very useful in helping identify companies that the subscriber wishes to research deeper and further. Later in tutorials, we will go through a more in-depth discussion of how to more effectively use the screening function. But this demo number 4 served as a simple introduction to the screening tool. Our next demo, demo number 5, will look at how to build and manage your portfolios. And we think you'll discover that the FastGraphs allows you to have more transparency in portfolio management than you've ever had before.